What would you do if I sang out of tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? He's not yet able to get the voice just right, so he's trying to stay in tune. Skipping to the last song, A Day in the Life, we hear of Paul's car accident. Theorists contend is about Paul's accident. Although the crowd thought it was somebody famous involved, they weren't sure. The news was covered up, so anyone who may have been a witness never knew for sure who it was. This song corroborates the belief that there was a car accident and that Paul died of head injuries. As the story went during the early morning sessions for Sergeant Pepper, Paul stormed out of the studios mad at the others, and after taking a few drinks, proceeded to drive off into the night. Some believe he picked up a hitchhiker named Rita, who, after recognizing her famous driver, jumped all over him, causing the accident. In another song on the LP, Lovely Rita, are the lines, I took her home, I nearly made it. Other lyrics of interest on the album include From Fixing a Hole, I'm fixing a hole where the rain gets in and stops my mind from wandering. Possibly a reference to an injury of the head. Within You, Without You says life flows on within you and without you. The Beatles went on without Paul. And even the innocent Good Morning tells us now you're in gear, a car, and nothing to do to save his life. The album, which was released after Sgt. Pepper, was the album in England of the EP of music from the film Magical Mystery Tour. The front cover was quite an eye-opener for clues. The most obvious thing is that all four Beatles are dressed in animal costumes. Foremost is the black walrus, which is Paul. The black is symbolic, again, of death, and the walrus was a bad omen to Viking hunters, for if they saw a dead walrus at the start of their journeys, they would turn back because of its negative symbolism. The yellow stars spelling out Beatles should also be examined. If the cover is held to a mirror and the largest stars are connected and read from the mirror, one can see seven digits, a phone number. According to how you hold the cover, whether upside down or not, these three phone numbers are agreed on as appearing. 834-1735, 483-5317, and 237-7038. It was common in the fall of 1969 to call these numbers in London. And it was rumored that, one, you would get a funeral parlor, or two, you would get an angry old lady whom you'd awaken from her sleep at 3 a.m., or three, the strangest story of all, as reported in a Washington, D.C. underground paper and simultaneously in a rumor sheet circulating through the music business in New York, was that you'd get someone answering the phone who would claim to be Billy Shears. After quizzing the caller on Beatle trivia, he would promise to send you tickets to Pepperland. It was reported that three Michigan students received such tickets in the mail with the inscription ADN on the envelope. Apparently, the stamps on the envelope, which the receiver was instructed to lick, were laced with LSD, because one of the Michigan students did lick them and jumped from the window as to his death. The second student claimed to have already been to Pepperland in the Caribbean Sea and was returning there on the upcoming November 27th. The third student, when queried, just laughed. By the way, if you call these numbers today, they're all out of service. The Magical Mystery Tour album contains a 24-page booklet, which contains some startling clues. On page 5 of the Magical Mystery Tour booklet is an interesting photo. We see the four Beatles dressed in their costumes with a black walrus at the piano. Behind the Beatles are men dressed as surgeons. These men symbolize the surgeons who tried to save Paul's life after the accident. On the concrete structure in back of them are policemen, representing the ones who appeared at the scene of the crash and who were paid off to hush up the whole affair. What is the concrete structure? It suggests an unmarked tomb. The top half of the photo on page 6 has a sign which says the best way to go is by M&D Company. M&D Company is a funeral company in London. Above that sign is a depart sign with a time, 8:34, the same three numbers which some see in the cover's phone number. But we can't see the arrive back time. Paul departed on that fateful night, but never arrived back. On page 9, there's a series of drawings which summarize the plot of the film. The middle drawing in the top row is of the Fool on the Hill. There's a drawing of Paul, and the L from Hill continues and splits Paul's head. The left bottom drawing shows all four Beatles, and again, John has his wizard cap, Paul has his black petals, and red nose. Black petals? The last drawing has a walrus devouring the bus while John appears smiling from a cracked egg. Underneath the bottom drawings in section 2 are the words, the bus is 10 miles north of the Dewsbury Road and they're having a lovely time. While this location is also mentioned in the film, its significance is not great unless this location, which is mentioned several times in the movie, is the scene of Paul's accident. There are those who suggest that it is not Paul sitting in the black walrus suit, but in section 12 are the words, I am the walrus, says John. No, you're not, cries Nicola. Here, then, is a firm denial of John as the walrus. On pages 12 and 13, there's a photo of the Beatles again with Paul being barefoot. This time, however, we're treated to the sight of his shoes. Look closely. His shoes are stained with blood. Some argue that the red is just a runoff printing error from the drum, but we can easily see that the shades of red are much different, and if it were simply a printing error, it would have been corrected on later copies. The stains are still on current pressings. The drum has a message for us, too. Written on the drum is the message, love the three Beatles. And we all know there are four Beatles, unless, of course. Everyone's favorite scene appears on page 23, with the Beatles decked out in white tuxedos. Notice that Paul has on a black carnation, while the others are wearing red. The Beatles said, we ran out of red ones and happened to find a black one backstage. Do you know how rare black carnations are? Not likely that one would be found lying around. The only other black or dead flowers are, in fact, being handed to Paul by the girl on the left of the picture. The final photo in the book on page 24 shows everyone happily waving at the camera. Look at the top row. You'll see that Paul is the only Beatle with a hand over his head. As with Sgt. Pepper, Magical Mystery Tour also contains the lyrics to the songs, which makes the task of finding clues so much easier. The title song hints at several aspects of Paul's death. The lines, the Magical Mystery Tour, dying to take you away, is thought by some to suggest the ambulance that took Paul's body away from the scene of the accident and inevitably to his final resting place. In Strawberry Fields Forever, listen closely to the end of the fade-out. You can make out the sound of John saying, I buried Paul. Let's listen again.